Hello yoga friends, and welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Jessica, and today we'll be doing a 30-minute restorative practice using a bolster. A rectangular bolster is great. If you don't have a bolster, just grab maybe a couch cushion or a thicker pillow is wonderful. So we'll start here in Sukhasana, easy pose, just coming into the present moment. This practice is wonderful to do after a workout or maybe right before you go to bed. So we're settling into our Sukhasana, bringing our hands down onto our knees, palms down for some grounding energy, or palms up to harness some energy from the universe. Feel free to flutter your eyes closed or take a soft gaze. Coming into the present moment, evening out the breath here, we'll begin our practice by setting an intention. Anything that comes to mind is wonderful. And if nothing comes to mind, you can always use this one. I am worthy of good things. I am worthy of good things. And whatever intention you chose for yourself today, begin to inhale the beautiful energy from that intention in through the nose, deep into the belly. And open the mouth, sigh. Exhale out anything extra you may have brought onto your mat today. Let's do that one more time. Inhaling deep into the belly. And open the mouth, sigh, exhale out anything extra, allowing all that air to escape and return to your even breath that you found at the beginning of class, knowing that you can always come back to your intention throughout practice if your mind begins to wander or throughout the rest of your day today. Next inhale, we're going to look up to the sky, gently pressing the torso forward for seated cow pose. Exhale, chin to chest, rounding the spine for cat. We're going to do this two more times, just working through our spine here before we move into our first restorative posture. And exhale to cat. Inhale to cow, making sure those shoulders are down and relaxed. And exhale to cat. Beautiful. Inhaling, coming back into Sukhasana. Maybe taking a few shoulder rolls here to the back. And let's reverse those to the front. And coming back to center, maybe take a neck roll over to the right. And reversing that over to the left. Just kind of seeing where we're at today. And inhaling back into Sukhasana. We're going to find our way down onto our backs here for our first restorative posture, bringing our bolster with us. We're going to set our bolster up on our right side of our body here. We're going to inhale the left leg into the chest and exhale, cross that left leg across the body onto the bolster, bringing the left arm out by the side into a T for a supine twist here. And you can adjust your bolster. Maybe it sits a little bit higher up. Finding a very comfortable position. Maybe you add an additional pillow if you feel any strain in the back. Make sure that your left shoulder remains on the ground here. If it's not, you might have to add that extra bolster or pillow. And fluttering the eyes closed or taking a soft gaze, returning to that even breath. We're going to settle in here for our first restorative posture. space to clear. Knowing that if any thoughts come to mind, acknowledge them and let them float on by. And we're about halfway through here. Just scanning the body. See if any tension has crept up that we can exhale. Making any minor adjustments that you need to. And continuing the even breath. And taking about three more rounds of breath here. Gently guide that left leg back into the chest here and allow both knees to bend, bringing the soles of the feet onto the earth, moving your bolster just off to the side here
And we're going to windshield wiper the knees from side to side. Very slowly here. Maybe moving with your breath. Let's do one more round. And we can return those knees towards the ceiling and straighten both legs. Bringing our bolster over to the left side of the body this time. We're going to inhale that right knee into the chest. And exhale, guide that right leg across the body, setting up for supine twist on the opposite side. Making sure that right shoulder remains in contact with the earth and option to gaze over the right fingertips. Making sure to take your time setting up in this posture, knowing that this side might feel different from the other side. And that's completely okay. And instead of judging our asymmetry, we should celebrate it. It's beginning to settle in here, into this posture, coming back to your even breath. Maybe even returning to your intention that you set at the beginning of class. And letting go here in this supine twist. And we're about halfway through this side. Making sure you're allowing your mind to stay clear Feel free to make any minor adjustments you need to. And continue to let go here. Taking about 3 more rounds of breath. And on your next inhale, gently guiding that right leg across the body so the knee ends up to the chest. Adjusting your bolster off to the side a little bit here and bringing that left knee into the chest as well. Let's take a few hip rolls here. And reverse those hip rolls. And bringing the knees back into the chest, maybe rocking from side to side, very gently. And we're going to exhale both legs back down. We're going to set up for supported fish pose. So gently coming up and sitting up, grabbing your bolster and placing your bolster so it's kind of long waves on your mat and bringing it just right behind your bum here. Next exhale, we're simply going to lay over the bolster, allowing our arms to come out to our sides, or maybe feels more comfortable with your hands resting on your belly or even the sides of your rib cage. Whatever feels comfortable here in the supportive fish. This is a beautiful chest opener here, heart opener. And fluttering your eyes closed or taking a soft gaze. We'll begin to relax in supported fish. our supported fish bones. Just scanning the body for any tension we can exhale. Making any minor adjustments. And allowing ourselves to release in this posture for a few more minutes. Taking three more rounds of breath here. Few rounds of breath, gently rolling to one side off your bolster, placing your bolster just to the side. We're going to come down onto our backs once more, setting up for our shavasana for the day. You can take a traditional shavasana by straightening your legs out, or you can join me in taking your bolster underneath your legs and taking shavasana this way. By placing a support underneath the legs here, it allows for a slight release in the lower back. Adjusting any clothing or hair that might be distracting, and bringing the arms out by the sides, or maybe hands rest on the belly or heart. Fluttering the eyes closed or taking a soft gaze. Scan the body to release any tension and allow yourself to stop being a human doing and just be a human being. I will let you know when it's time to come out of your shavasana, but for now, simply rest. You're welcome to stay in your shavasana for as long as you'd like. But if you'd like to close out class with me, begin to bring awareness back to your breath. Introducing some movement into your body by wiggling your fingers and toes. Maybe rolling through the wrists and ankles. Bringing your knees into your chest and giving yourself a nice little hug. Finding any organic movement to wake the body up. Before gently coming onto one side for a fetal position. Keeping your legs bent and using your bottom arm as a pillow. On your next inhale, gently press up into your Sukhasana. Maybe keeping your eyes closed or in a soft gaze here, bringing hands to heart center. I want to thank you for coming to practice with me today, and I look forward to seeing you again soon on your mat. We'll close our practice with the sound of Om, inhaling through the nose deep into the belly. Om. And bringing thumbs to third eye. May the light and love in me recognize and honor the light and love in you. Namaste.